Have a seat.
Have a seat.
Put your name here. Put your address, please. You intend to start tomorrow morning?
Yeah.
Where do you sleep this night? I don't know. Okay. Maybe the place in 55. Maybe. If you don't have 5, you come back here.
Okay.
Try it because it's a municipal auberge. It's cheaper.
Okay. Bonjour.
Monsieur là.
Un croissant, s'il vous plaît.
Un croissant. Ok.
I just came across a book over Christmas called The Road to Santiago, and when I saw it, I saw about the pilgrimage and it being a spiritual thing, I thought maybe that's something for me.
I've wanted to do it. I had a friend who did it and it kind of stuck with me a few years ago, and then it's this kind of weird, compelling thing that every time it came up, I'd get the sense, like, I'd pick up a book at a bookstore and it'd be about the Camino, and it'd be like, oh, I have to do that. And I didn't necessarily have a when in mind. And then it kind of tumbled into that it was a good time to do it, and I felt like I had to.
I woke up about 6:30 and hit the road about 7. Most people were gone by the time I got up, stopped for breakfast, had a nice breakfast, and just enjoying the beautiful early morning sunshine.
I've been thinking about it for years, but I could never get the time off work. Like, I've done lots of other hikes over the years, but this is kind of flawless, the big long one that you always wanted to do, but you could never really get around to it. So it's just been in the back of my mind for a long time.
Oh,
up for 11, it seems. And we realized there's two types of Camino people. There's the like busy bees who get up early in the morning at like 5:30 when it's still dark, and sort of like motor along. And then there's the sort of tortoises. And I think we fall into the tortoise category.
I would give us more credit than tortoise.
Maybe. What's faster than a tortoise? Like,
it's like cruising speed.
Cruising speed.
Yeah.
We're the cruisers.
Yeah.
So we're taking our time.
Yes, I am.
Now when we talk about it,
yeah. Usually the comfort zone here is about 1 millimeter.
1 millimeter?
Yeah.
Oh, it's so close, yeah. Oh, just the no sheets thing, and, you know. Yeah.
What about the bad bugs?
At the toilets? They shed toilet things. Bed bunks.
No.
Yeah, I could deal with that. It is close. It's like close quarters, and the snoring thing is like worrying.
Morning on the Camino starts with a nice cup of coffee. Por favor, una desayuno.
We've arrived in Barcelona about 3 o'clock. This fine specimen of a man did it in 4 hours. We were here by 12.
Yes, Ross.
What time did you leave?
10 to 12.
10 to 12.
Shit, it's not like, I was thinking you must have left at 6.
Hold on. That's a little over 10.
4 hours is a very good effort.
You had a good plan.
Myself.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
we sort of leave it around about that same time?
We left at 8. And we got here at 3.
Maybe we are tortoises.
Yeah.
You either like someone and you know it, or you like someone
haven't
you, and
you
don't.
Exactly. You can not like someone and try and convince yourself that you like
yes.
them, and you can do that for a long time. But when it comes down to it, the gut instinct was that you never liked them.
Yeah, exactly. But I wanted to work.
I was chatting to a girl the other day before I went to Camino, and she said she dated a guy for a year and a half. And she said, actually, I didn't love him. And I was like, you dated someone for a year and a half, and you didn't love him.
That's
she was like,
ridiculously common.
That's so common.
Yeah.
I have friends that are probably going to marry people that they, if you were to like, after the first date, they were like, eh.
And they're going to get married.
Because they're like, well, that's good. I love them. And it's like,
yeah, if you love them, why are you in love with them? You can love someone and spend all your time with them
yeah.
and have a great time, lots of fun and everything. But if you're not in love with them,
it's
not going to work. I'm trying to tell you something the rest of your life.
But what if you're like,
because I never did something on my own, so I really want to figure out if I can do something on my own. And another reason is that I want to finish some parts of my life. So for example, I graduated in school and now I have to find a job. And another reason is that my boyfriend broke up with me, so I want to finish that part and move on. I think that's are the main reasons. Yeah.
Do you have any life events happen that made you decide to do the Camino?
I had cancer and I got better. Well, I was well, and so I wanted to do something that was just going to prove that I was alive. And that's why I walked the first time, and now just because I'm addicted. But I think I need to walk somewhere else and not the Camino.
This is our hostel for the night. James is down there. This is my bed.
Hello.
Hopefully it'll be comfortable.
I think it's really magical. I'm still amazed how the days are going. The way I walk, the walks are great. It's good weather. But especially the people and the feeling on the Camino and you can't walk by people without looking them in the eye and telling them a Bien Camino or talking to them or And well, the people were sitting here with it's I don't know the way it, I haven't left as hard and as much as in the past 4 days than months. It's really great and I love it actually.
So what's for dinner?
What
are we having for dinner? What
I'm
are you having?
Having macaroni, meatballs, and mousse. Macaroni, meatballs, and mousse.
Why meatballs? Everyone's having meatballs today. You have meatballs?
Of course I have meatballs.
You have meatballs?
Meatballs? Yeah. I'm a vegetarian.
So it's day 5 and I just got up. I'm on the road now about 8 o'clock. Had breakfast included in the hostel that I'm staying in. A little bit of bread, keep me going. I think I'm going to try to do 23 kilometers today to a town called Estrella. It's getting a little easier each day, so I think I should be able to do that quite easily.
For many reasons, I just got out of the military, so I'm starting to understand the life process, how cyclical it is. I've had some more personal things that have come up to this point that, you know, the Camino would help with a little time frame of thinking. And I definitely have religious and spiritual reasons also why I'm here, yes, for sure.
This is Jan from Slovenia.
Slovenia, right.
What day are you on now?
Honestly, I have to think about it. It's like the 6th day, I think, since we left San John.
And you enjoying your Camino so far?
It's wonderful. I mean, it's been everything I'd expected. And hi, hello, Ben Camino.
Ben Camino.
And a lot of stuff I didn't expect. It's actually pleasant and. The walks are good. The Pyrenees went through, so so far so good.
You are collecting litter?
Yes.
The whole way to Santiago?
Yes.
Cool. Why you decide to do this?
Why?
Yeah.
Because this earth is not mine. It's from God.
Okay.
And God gave me everything. So I don't understand why the people they put trash in the Camino.
Right.
So it's only by your respect of God, only.
Oh, good for you. Well done.
Buen día. Pasaporte.
¿Cuánto costa?
6 euros.
Well, finally made it to. Stay. And 2 blisters on my feet, very sore, quite tired. Hey,
Anne. Oh, hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Sore.
Got yeah, a couple of blisters. We just got back.
Yeah. Been here for ages, have you?
No. No, just take a quick shower and. Woo! Yeah.
So. After a long day of walk, usually unpack everything.
And the towel is always at the bottom of my backpack. But shower is the first thing usually. So I'm gonna do that now.
Welcome to today's series of the foot doctor. today my patient is poor old Margaret. Margaret, what's happening?
When I was in London, I got a little crack in my heel and I moisturized it, you know, I kinda kept it antibacterial stuff on it. Now I think I have a callus underneath it, so it just looks like my heels are rubbing a little bit. Yesterday it was a little more like that, but like you said, it was a lot more split. And now it just seems to have like kind of bulged a little today.
And what's your theory on this bit here?
I'm hoping that it's a callus like this bit, because it feels like this bit did yesterday.
Do you think there's any water on it?
That's what I mean, like a water booster that turns to a bit of a callus, because yesterday this was more watery.
I had a crack in my heel.
Yes.
And now it's just kind of swelling up a bit.
You can.
Should I do that?
Yes.
I wasn't sure if I should or if that would be worse.
You can, and you can antiseptic.
Yeah.
And before, no, and see, you can put one of these.
So pop it and then drain it, put anti-infection stuff, and then put that on?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
You just, it's luck. You have problems with your feet or not? And I'm a person who has no problem with your feet. So I'm lucky.
That's it. Is there any water coming out?
I think the needle's blocking it. Oh, ew. I just dripped.
Yeah.
You gotta go sideways.
This way?
Yeah. This still goes through it. And push it right through the other end.
Yeah? Oh, this is the tension, right?
You love it, don't you? Hey? It's like tension from the girls.
Yeah?
Yeah, just
chew.
Just press
the stuff out. Chew.
Number two.
You're gonna go in again?
Please, two.
Oh, geez, that's weird, isn't it?
You need one.
Get some Vaseline in there. You won't have any of this happening.
I want to see.
Does it zoom in enough? Will it take it?
Yeah. Probably do that.
Yeah. Is the wine good?
Hey, how are you guys?
Yeah, good.
What's your name?
John. Prost.
Not all of the Camino is like breathtakingly beautiful. You have to sometimes walk under roads, beside highways, through towns. So you're walking across country, so it's pretty varied. And I like that about it. And then you suddenly come into like a beautiful field, like this. Beautiful scenery. So far it's been good. Yeah. The first day crossing the Pyrenees was hard work, but it was always going to be hard work.
Yeah.
But no, it's been terrific. It's great to see some beautiful countryside, some historic buildings and towns and cities and so forth that you've read about but never seen.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, every corner there's something new to look at, so it's been terrific, yeah.
And do you find it social?
Exceedingly social. Everyone's very friendly.
Yeah.
All the locals are very friendly, very helpful. That was a bit of a surprise.
Yeah,
and how helpful everyone was.
Are you staying in the auberges?
Yeah, yeah.
Yep.
Yep.
You finding the snoring a problem?
It's not good.
not good. The last two nights we stayed in two private ones, but not in the major centres.
Okay.
In a small village, and that was 10 out of 10 each time.
Oh, right.
Great places and much quieter.
Okay.
Yeah. So maybe that's the way to go rather than the more public ones.
Well, I try to pick the cheapest one. Right. I'm on a budget.
Okay. Well, they were only a couple of euros more, so.
Okay.
But it was worth it for the good night's sleep.
Great. You got earplugs.
Yep.
Dormitory tonight. 30 odd bags, 40 bags. Mm-hmm.
I would say the whole bunch of people that is walking along the Camino is an unspoken community. It's a soul community. Everybody shares the same feeling. Everybody has the same goal. Everybody shares the same pains. Shares the same menu for El Peregrino.
It is extremely social, I think. Yeah.
You connect very, very, very easy. And you see that when the eyes from people that they get sometimes a little bit emotional because you have a connection. That's nice.
One thing I really enjoy about the Camino is the quality of relationships that you have with people. There's a real honesty and authenticity and integrity. And, like, I've told people things on the walk that I haven't told some of my good friends. I have bipolar disorder, which is a mood disorder. Affects your mood, so you can go up, but you can also get very depressed. So I've experienced periods of bad depression in my life and isolation, social anxiety, and I've also had the highs, which are leave me elated and kind of out of control. And it's often something I kind of hide from people, that I don't really open up and talk about it. Whereas on the Camino, it just feels a sort of sense of you get to know people a lot better. Like already with James and Margaret, who've been traveling with for a few days. We've shared some very, very personal stuff. Stuff that you'd only really share with best friends. And I think that's one of the qualities of coming on this walk, is that people who are doing this walk are open to it. You know, they're not superficial. They're usually quite meditative, deep people. So they're understanding that life can be hard sometimes and it can be full of tragedy and difficulty. And also joy and great fun. So I like that about the Camino, the way that there's a blend of fun, because you're often tired, you laugh at like really silly things and you joke about it. In the evening it's very social, you have drinks and share food together, and but it's also time where you can sort of walk out on your own and just enjoy the nature. And so it's a very simple thing to be doing, really, just walking every day for 34 days till you reach your goal. But it's very relaxing, and you take in some amazing nature.
With a lot of people, I have very good conversations about life and about relationships and things. But there are also moments that we just having fun.
Today it's 10 o'clock and we're just leaving the Pilgrim, and I'm very sore. I've got two pairs of socks on, double socking, and got 5 blisters, and my feet are hurt already. How about you?
Just exhausted after the 28 kilometers yesterday, and sore. I think everyone's sore though. This is the start.
nicer than I imagined. I thought some of them might be beat down or kind of old or maybe dirty, and that hasn't been the case at all. They've been really clean. Some have been more rudimentary or more simple than others, but they've all been pretty clean.
Of course you should not expect any luxury. I don't know, no one is expecting anything luxurious. But I find it's okay. I don't have problems with snoring. I sleep well, I'm a deep sleeper. And I use earplugs, so I don't hear anything.
What's that? Second coffee? How are you feeling today?
Okay. Pretty alright. Fairly sprightly. Yeah. Set 15 to go, not bad. Better than yesterday. Ah, from an axle. Miller, screw my neck.
That sounds a bit whingy.
Whingy?
Yeah.
Well, I always whingy.
So one thing we've been discussing on the Camino is the importance of friendship, and these two have become like our little inner circle.
And, should it be an inner triangle?
An inner triangle. And we meet lots of people each day, and you know, there's lots of casual friends, people you can talk to in the evening and have drinks with.
The coitus.
That you call friends. Then there's some people you can just like walk all day with, you can talk craft. Tell them important stuff and
okay, squeeze their blisters.
Squeeze their blisters. Tell them embarrassing stuff. Notice when they're a little down and cheer them up, or notice when they're pissed off with you and then they can get pissed off with you. Whereas other people you can't really get pissed off with them because they just move away. But so like I don't know, I think we're lucky to find some good friends on the Camino. I think that's one of the really special things about this walk, is, and about anything in life, is friendship, sharing. Wow, this place is big.
Hello again.
Hello, hello.
Hello, hello.
7? Is it the one with the door open?
Yeah. Super
Good appetite to everybody. No, because one of the guys I was talking with, he said.
Last night we had dinner with a gentleman who sat down on our table, and we'd never met him before, and after some casual conversation and halfway through the starter, soon we were talking about relationships, and he told us about an affair he'd been having in his marriage, and that he'd come on the Camino because he didn't know what to do, if he should stay with his wife or if he should leave her. And he talked about that every relationship evolves, like he'd been with his wife for 17 years, and he said that the sexual part had diminished, and that's what he got. He felt the affair gave him the chance to have passion and excitement. So it was interesting listening to an older guy's story. But that's just the amazing thing about the Camino, is like, how often do people open up and tell you about their reasons and troubles for first time meeting them? It was like a conversation you'd have with an old friend. So it was quite insightful and interesting. Today, I'm doing 24Ks, a little further than I thought I'd do. And feet are holding up all right. It's quite pretty around here. It was a bit dull earlier on. But just gotta keep moving step by step, and we'll get there.
So I finished walking 24 kilometers. We are now in a little town called
San Juan.
San Juan de Ortego.
This one?
And here we have cameras. All
top bunks have been taken.
As usual.
Margaret, what do you do when you arrive in the albergs?
Nothing. My favorite thing is to just lie down until I eventually get the energy to shower.
And then what do you do?
Wine.
And then what do you do?
Eat. Mentally.
What time do you go to bed?
Between 9 and 10. 10 if it's a really late night.
When I get into the hostel, I lie in my bed for a bit. And then I have a shower.
It makes you do
and then I sometimes go and drink a beer.
AKA every day.
Alright, most days. But there's not really that much else to do. Like, you get in at 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
How many shower rooms?
Dinner's not till 7, so you can clean your clothes, you can lie in your bed, you can check your Wi-Fi.
I hope one.
We should talk about how miserable today is.
Today's a bit miserable. Why?
Tell us.
Is it that bad?
Yeah, today's a miserable day. I think we go through days where they're really good, we feel hyped up, and then we have days like this where we're just like, we just want to get to town, and you're walking through a forest that's just a straight line.
See, I didn't think today was that bad. I mean, the forest was miserable, because yesterday was so bad that it didn't feel nearly as bad.
I'm just not feeling this alberg.
How are your feet?
Not great, but much better than yesterday.
Mm-hmm. You think you'll make it?
Yeah. If I have to crawl on my flip-flops, I'll eventually get there.
Do some days you're like, do you find it hard? Like it's unpleasurable?
The last couple of days, yeah. Yesterday was particularly bad, but...
Literally?
I should be doing this on YouTube.
I was six months old, younger. So this is a Pilgrim's menu. Really big starter, fish and chips main course, bottle of wine for €4, and the wine is very good. Very good. What do you think of the food?
This is, well, we've had much better than this.
We've had better than this.
Much, much better.
Hey? Boo for
$7.50.
It's good. Today's the first day of not great weather. It's raining and it's a little cold. I'm dressed in my what looks like a big bin bag. Poncho. I've got 26 k, so it's quite a long way.
Last bed, or non-bed, and I'm going to be
staying here for the night.
I have no right to call myself one who knows. I was one who seeks, and I still am. But I no longer seek in the stars or in the books. I'm beginning to hear the teachings of my blood pulsing within me. My story isn't pleasant, it's not sweet and harmonious like the invented stories. It tastes of folly and bewilderment, of madness and dream, like the life of all people.
Camino, there are these places called auberges, which are hostels where you can stay in. And most days you just walk until you feel like you can't go any further, and then you just decide to stay in that town and get a bed. But today we decided to reserve a bed because we've had a few nights where we've arrived in the town and all the hostels have been booked out. So sometimes just gives you a bit of peace of mind if you book ahead, then you don't have to stress about not getting a bed and wondering where you're going to sleep. Are we going to get this all in one wash?
Sorry?
Okay, sure. We need just that.
We can use this.
Look away.
Today's a typical day. We're just kind of like walking between towns. We're stopping off for lunch. The scenery's good, but we're kind of just focusing on getting to the next place. It's kind of like business as usual. That's the feeling.
Oranges and apples and a little bit of tomato.
Initially, I just wanted a long walk. But to be completely honest, I didn't realize how much I needed. The first time you, Jamie, interviewed me, I was still under the impression I just wanted to walk. And think, and walk, and think. But the people I've met, the crack I've had, has just been amazing. I don't think I realized how much stress I was under until I actually wasn't under anymore.
This is like exactly where I want to be. Yeah, it's probably the best thing I've ever done for myself. And it's not somebody else telling me what I should be doing. It's just me deciding what I want to do and not really thinking about the consequences as such.
Thank you.
whole way?
Yeah.
Really? To Santiago?
Yes, it's Santiago.
When did you start?
1 month ago. And
it's...
10 kilos.
Did you sleep the night in the hostel?
Yeah.
Did you feel good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Beautiful thing about the Camino. In one way, you can meet people all around the world with different cultures, different languages.
The problem was, Lake's nice putting him on.
Buen Camino.
I found out, I was talking to James about how they might have gotten affected, and I think it's that I used the pin to pop the infected one, and then my new blister I popped with the same pin. Because I was saying, how did they both get infected? And then it's kind of my fault.
The one thing you got to be careful on the Camino is getting waterproof boots, because if you get waterproof boots, you risk getting swamp foot. And this is swamp foot. Like, it looks like I've been in the swimming pool for the last 4 hours. It's really soft. It's like trench foot in the water. And that's what I risk getting. But they dry out, and then the next day they get wet again. But yeah, it's a bit uncomfortable. So don't get too thick hiking boots when you go on the Camino. Get nice boots, breathable ones.
Donate, how much you're willing to donate?
connecting this little
box here.
So,
que yo no quiera hablar inglés no quiere decir que no te entienda.
Okay.
Okay.
I what do you think I should give? 5 euro? 3 euro? 2 euro?
1 euro.
Okay.
Ahora vas a fumar. Oh, ahora fumar. Saca, espera, sácale la foto. Ahí.
So this is my bunk up here.
Thank you. Muchas gracias.
So yesterday I managed to lose my friends who I've been traveling with pretty much for the last 3 weeks. I just stayed in a town which was one town short of where they were staying. I misread the kilometers and I thought I was there. Checked into a hostel and then realized that none of them were there. And in a way it was a good experience because, you know, it's good to spend some time on your own in the Camino and meet new people. And but in a way it was kind of hard because I had to talk to new people and meet new people, and I missed playing cards and joking about with the group I'd been with. But I don't think you should do the Camino if you're traveling on your own. It's probably good to have days where you don't bump into the same people, where you have to go out of your comfort zone and talk to new people and make new friends at each place. But today I've decided I'm going to catch up with them. So it means I've got a much longer day than I had hoped for. I've got to do about 31 kilometers, which with the state of my feet is quite challenging. It's not really about fitness for me, it's just about how my feet are at the end of the day. So I'm going to head to Astorga. And we've got one more stop in a town in about 5k, and after that then there's nowhere to stop. So once I decide to do it, I've got to do it. There's no way I can stop short and just pop into a hostel on the way, because there isn't any. So hopefully it'll be alright. I've done about 8k now, just stopped for breakfast, and feet feel fine, so hopefully should be able to keep going for the day.
¿Cuánto tiempo a
Santiago?
And then Santiago, Bilbao?
No, Bilbao, Santiago.
Okay.
39. Santiago, Bilbao? No sé.
And you dormi al albergue?
Tienda de campaña, tienda.
Camping?
Camping, sí, tienda. Donde hay hierba para la burra, hierba para comer.
Muy bien. Muy bien.
Muy bien.
Ok.
Vale.
Hasta luego.
Vale, buen camino.
Buen camino.
Venga,
how long you guys been here?
Yeah.
1 hour?
Yeah.
And I left at 8 o'clock.
Good to see you.
How are you?
Yeah, good. You actually look like you're like pepping your step.
Really?
Yeah.
A bit exhausted. Are you in San? Yeah, yeah, 31.
San Rafael or something?
San something, yeah.
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 Is it far?
It's about 2K.
One?
It's like 1.5.
4 euros.
Thank you.
Stone, a symbol of my efforts on the pilgrimage, that I lay at the foot of the cross of the Saviour, one day weigh the balance in favour of my good deeds, and the deeds of my life are judged.
Let it be so.
The hills are alive with the sound of music.
We went on the Camino spontaneously, me and my girlfriend at least, and we joined up with Roland and Rosinante later.
Now we have an international.
We have an international donkey caravan. So it's Portuguese is our donkey, Spanish is Rosinante, Roland is from Hungary, Anna is from Germany, and I am from the Netherlands. At night, well, we sleep outside, and the donkeys sleep outside as well. Sometimes, if it's very bad weather, we need to find a shelter for them, but donkeys, they're very tough animals.
So you camp?
Yeah, we camp most of the time.
Wow.
Last night we slept in a Donativo alberg, and it also happened that people invited us into our homes, but that's very special. It doesn't happen every day or every week or every month.
It's like being on top of the world up there.
So beautiful.
Right, 3, 2, 1, go! Ah, shit. No, you had no chance.
Is it warm, Margaret?
No.
Nice.
Refreshing.
That's good for the muscles.
Invigorating, actually.
Yeah, that's a good word. Invigorating.
Usually we breakfast on the Camino consists of café con leche and a croissant or maybe a pan of chocolate, but today we splashed out with a desayuno especial. We have eggs, bacon, beans, and bread, and coffee and orange juice. But we deserved it because we walked 8K. So
James and Margaret had a big fallout last night. They had a big argument, and we've been on the road together for 30 days, so I guess it's pretty natural people get upset about things, but James decided to walk on today, so he's no longer walking with us. See, him and Margaret decided to go separate ways, which is a real shame, because he's become a very good friend on the Camino, so hopefully I'll get to see him again in Santiago. I wish him a good, a buen Camino. My room.
Venga, Marc, hasta pronto.
Pues muchas gracias.
Hasta luego.
Mamá, ¿dónde está arriba?
Pensaba que era un cachuelo, pero no lo de arriba.
Lo que el futuro me deparaba. ¿Qué? Iban pateando al luz. Niño toca la guitarra. El otro se estaba buscando. Mi niña bailaba. Al compás de dularía. Mientras le tocó.
Ah, sí, si viene la abuela a buscarte.
Los sueños, sueños.
Ah, llegó, sí, llegó a las 12.
El destino decidirá lo que el futuro me espera y si mi sueño se cumplirá. A Dios le estoy pidiendo
Pablo,
que se haga realidad. Pues me paso el día durmiendo y para encontrar la felicidad. Puedo besarla cada mañana. Mira para la y ver la tumbada en mi cama. Será mi noche. Era mi día, mi estrella blanca y una casita en el barrio de Santa Cruz. Un ventana y un pequeño patio andaluz. Enredadera que sube por la escalera. Por una rea se desorienta la luz. Y cuando llega la noche a mi ventana, coja mi ni huele la flor de mi dama. En mi vieja mecedora que dormío. Al despertar del sueño todo se había ido.
What, if anything, do you think will have changed in you by the time you've come back?
I feel that I won't be suffering. I won't be. I felt like I was really kind of locked in this kind of a depression. You know, I was like still holding on to the future that I imagined with my family. That kind of propelled me into the future. I was still holding on to that, even though I had been divorced and separated. It was difficult to let go of it. And through this process and sharing my story, and then also visiting this site, the cross where we put down a rock that symbolized a burden that I'd been carrying for a while. I felt a lot of relief when I left that rock. I mean, initially I felt a lot of grief and kind of mourning, and a lot of emotions came up. After that, I felt, aside from being exhausted, I also felt relieved that I just wasn't suffering as much anymore, and that there's a possibility of a new future ahead. Yeah, I feel that actually more now than ever.
Bueno.
Ducha?
Okay.
Hey.
mountains in on the Camino are not just limited to the Pyrenees. We're just entering Galicia today. We have one of the hardest climbs. We've got an elevation of about 1,200 meters and in 8 kilometers, I think we go up about 600 or 700 meters, something like that. And so today's quite challenging. So much so that Margaret has decided to get a horse. So you can rent a horse to take you the 8K. And we're gonna meet up with her later because her feet are bad. But it's still beautiful scenery. And I'm enjoying the challenge. So we've arrived in Galicia. Perfect.
Can't do it better. Feet on.
Here we go to Santiago. This is our dinner. Bottle of wine, €4.50. Lasagna, €4.50.
Yep.
Spaghetti, €5. We pretty much think we could eat and drink and get drunk for about 10, 15 euros max.
Probably. You drank all their cider.
Yep. So this is a value meal and the food is excellent. So I'm enjoying it.
Highly recommend this place.
Yeah, very good. Where are we?
Fuck the vine. feel of something.
It's good. Yeah. Find it.
Greatest things would make me sing. Oh, but I'm
los corazones. Es el lunar que tiene cielito lindo junto a la boca. No se lo ves a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegra cielito lindo los corazones.
I'm starting the walk from Saria. It's a lot busier because about 80% of the people who walk the Camino actually start in Saria, and only 10% start in Saint-Jean and 10% on all the other routes. So I decided to book ahead today just to make sure I get a bed so I'm not having to rush and stress. But yeah, it's a lot more busy, a lot more people on the trail, and a lot more Spanish as well. But it's good, so get to meet some new people. So, back on the road, 5 days to Santiago, and Peter holding up all right. Kind of getting Santiago fever, like, kind of want to get there. But I'm not in a rush, so things are good. So this is what a 10 euro gets you in here. It's quite a nice bunk bed, small room, 4 beds, shouldn't be too noisy, really clean, nice bathroom. I'm happy, it's good. Shower time.
So this morning I'm walking from Puerto Marin to
What story did you like?
I actually arrived in Sarria.
Okay. Careful for you. You arrived in Sarria on Wednesday 21st. Yeah. To do the last week of the Camino with us. Prior to that, she had 4 days doing yoga and getting pissed in Alcantara.
Hello, Fanola. So how are you finding the Camino so far?
Great, better than expected. Sore on the feet than I was expecting, but nice and flat. Very social. Nice and cool.
So this is Fanola. Wait.
So my mom arrived in the same day as Fanola, and she is siesting now, like a proper Spaniard. I think our beers are going to another table.
Is she going with us for hours?
So everyone's got their new friends or new pals, and I've been abandoned. Now I gotta stay in the alberg on my own, make new friends, like first day of school again. But business has resumed because we've taught Fiona how to play wizard, and we've been having a bit of wizzy action, playing a bit of cards, and we still meet up on the end of the day, so. And we are how many days out?
It's
3 days out.
Wow.
That's scary. Only 3 days left.
3 days.
But what are we gonna do when we don't have to walk in?
We're gonna get drunk.
So Margaret, can you describe what we have for dinner?
We're having now the local cheese, the delicacy. Is Wubu say delicacy? I don't know. It's a very bland tofu texture like cheese. That's all I got.
What do we eat for dinner?
Potatoes bravas, meat, cheese, and a lot of potatoes. I haven't got much for you today.
Peppers.
Not enough drinking. Oh, peppers. We have peppers.
Do you enjoy now?
I enjoyed most of it, yes. Enjoyed all of it. I don't eat olives. Let them burn.
Go on, for how we got the olives.
But overall, good cheese, good meat, good chips, good pork, good everything. Good wine. Cheap wine.
And this is Gabriela.
Hello.
From Brazil. And you, where did you start, Gabriela?
Not hard way to do, 5 days, 2 weeks. It's gonna be okay.
You enjoying it?
Yeah, I love it.
And this is Margaret's mom.
No, you're good.
Camera popped over.
Hello.
All right.
Gonna be family.
One of the lovely things about the Camino is that the landscape is really varied. So in Galicia, there's lots of woodlands that you walk through, and it's a lot of dappled light, and it's really pretty. Whereas the Mesetas is a lot of open landscapes, flat, and then you have mountains coming into Galicia, and you've got mountains in the Pyrenees. Even the towns feel different along the way, and the food changes slightly. So from that point of view, the variety keeps it really interesting and really exciting. Enjoy that.
We really immediately liked each other because we had like really good friends, but we were just not thinking about love because we were doing a pilgrimage. So yeah. It didn't came up in my mind. But when Francisco said at a certain point, he said something to me.
We were talking about snoring and making loud noises at night.
Because I snore and Francisco snored.
Yeah.
So people didn't want to sleep next to me. But Francisco said at a certain point, he said, "Jeanette, when you snore, I love to cuddle with you." And I thought, what? Cuddle with me? That means knuffelen in Dutch. I think he feel more for me than only a friend. The next day he said exactly the same thing, and then I knew for sure. that he felt more for me. And then I started searching into my life, in my heart, what do I feel for him? And I thought, well, let's give him a good night kiss. And that was the beginning.
Yeah, that was a start.
And that felt good. And that was the beginning of falling in love.
Benefits of coming on El Camino. Everything just keeps on going. You don't stop, you don't. Because there's that, when you take a big breath in, and then suddenly your breath is caught, and you think, okay, I have a choice to make. Either I can fall and crumble, or I can keep going. And I think El Camino is a beautiful metaphor for that in life, because you just gotta keep walking.
Camino has been the most wonderful and amazing experience in my life. When we started, before we came to Spain to start with, all the questions we had about the Camino were about the physical challenge, how hard the walk was going to be, what sort of equipment we needed. What I've learned along the way is the Camino is about people, and the Camino is about sharing those who do the Camino with you. And the most important thing in life is the friendship of people and caring for those that are close to you. And it's truly been a wonderful experience for me, and I thank everyone who's been on it with me.
This is a little donativo stop on the Camino, and there's lots of these along the way. And you can these are good, fresh peaches. They got cherries up there. Got loads of nuts and snacks, even a little bit of cake. Unfortunately, there's nothing to drink. I wouldn't mind something to drink. I think I'm gonna get this peach. And you just put the money in the box, and someone gets it. So we started out on day one together. I think we walked out of the first hostel in St. John.
Said, hey, wanna walk together for a while?
36 37 days. 37 days later, we see twin peaks of the cathedral of Santiago de Compostela.
We made it.
5K.
We've almost made it. There's, for anybody who's thinking about doing the Camino, if you feel like you should do it, I think there's a reason you're called. Everything seems to work out in its own way. You just kind of have to let go and let it happen. You expect to walk alone. You end up meeting these wonderful people that you spend 37 days with. You expect to be confused about one thing and other things from your past come up, but it's so cathartic, I guess, because whatever you're holding on to, you learn to let go, walk forward, you followed the yellow arrows, and it's pretty exciting to be coming into Santiago and feel like, to look back at the beginning, that we haven't just changed where we are, but maybe who we are as well.
We made it!
Yay. Yeah, one piece, all legs, all toes, all fingers.
Not all our skin, but
yeah, we lost layers.
All skin. 37 days. And we made it.
A few blisters here and there.
Many a blister.
French foot. Yeah. Old muscles. Hands in our hole.
A lot of chafing for poor jeans.
Yeah. A lot of friends to help rub it in.
Now we just have to go get our
Compostela.
Compostela, yes. Yeah.
Oh my God, guys. Yay.
So I did it. I made it to Santiago. You can see behind me the cathedral. And it was a really great sense of accomplishment getting here. 37 days. Probably 7 or 8, maybe 9 blisters, chafing, sore feet, sunburn, you know, the works.
And yeah, I was very, very happy that it was the end of the Camino. But it was a little bit of mixed feelings because I had a great time and now it's the end, so yeah.
How do I feel? Feel like I could catch a taxi and feel cool about it, you know, something like that. Anything goes, yeah.
Rewarding, maybe one of the most accomplishing things I've ever done. Definitely more accomplishing than university. The military was accomplishing, it had its moments, but I think this was one task. You did it.
Mardi Gras.
And yeah, it's very, very rewarding.
For the day or two before getting here.
All done.
Yeah, well, I was officially here. Coming on. I didn't really want it to finish. I was having so much fun. So much laughter, so much wine.
I just think if anybody is watching this or heard about the Camino, they need to go and do it. And because it completely changes who you are.
The Camino for me has really been a reaffirming experience of just being grateful for the things I have in my life and grateful for the people I have in my life and how important it is to share your life with people, whether it's good friends or relationships. But for me, that's the one thing I've spent a lot of time thinking about her, kind of meditating about our relationship, and so hopefully it'll bring us closer together. So yeah, in a way, I think it's changed me and healed me in a positive way. Made me reflect on the things I have in my life, whereas a lot of the time I think it's easy for people to think, oh, if only I had this, if only I had this, and notice their shortcomings and notice the things that they don't have. The Camino has taught me to value the things I do have and to really cherish them. So yeah, that's what I'll take from the Camino.
Camino was probably one of the best things I've ever done. It was like brilliant people, brilliant fun.
Yeah, I think I'm more open now, or I was already open, but now in a different way. So I think I want to travel more. And yeah, I'm more, now I know that I can do things on my own without any problems, and yeah.
I think life's about challenging yourself, you know, whether it's doing any task, but the Camino in particular is this pilgrimage where you can challenge yourself physically, you can challenge yourself emotionally and mentally, and it completely takes you out of your normal life and puts you into this life where you don't know where you're going to sleep for the night. You're wondering if money is something that you should worry about. It's kind of combining everything that you live in your normal life. It's putting it together, but then it's not overbearing.
I feel like kind of the theme for me was letting go, and whether it was letting go of anger or regret or even just letting go of control a bit. And one of the big things was that I had the blisters, and I kind of came to the point when I had to take the days off. It was like, from this point forward, I'm either gonna stay back and stay by myself, or and be able to say I walked every single kilometer, or I could take a bus. And the way that I envisioned it was definitely like, under no circumstances am I busing or cabbing, like I'm walking the whole thing. And that's certainly what I would have liked to do, but to kind of realize the value that the people I was traveling with, the value they had and what they offered me, it was to let go of the idea I had of it and of this like idea of doing it perfectly or doing it the right way, and saying like sometimes you just have to weigh out what's more important, and the relationships I had made with those people kind of took priority over the pride of being able to say I didn't bus. But being able to like let go of the idea of that and just kind of going with it and letting it fall into place is definitely something I want to be conscious of bringing back home.
I'm just glad to know that even if I'm not here at the Camino, to know that this structure is available to me in the future as a way of working through life's transitions, whether it's divorce, death of loved ones, or some other challenge. Knowing that this structure is here gives me some peace too. And I think I'll be back and do one form of the Camino or another at some point in my life.